Things back there?
Oh, it's fine. Slow. I'm glad we're only a quarter full.
Same up here.
Did you hear something about the weather front?
Yeah, these things used to bother me.
The weather?
No.
That we're going to be delayed getting into Paris.
Please tell me you plan on getting some sleep tonight.
Oh, I can promise you we'll be in bed early.
Emily, why don't you go out with us? It'll be so fun.
Wow, Paris at night. The Champs-Élysées, the clubs, the memories.
I'll be busy. Now, if you please excuse me, ladies, I've got some work to do.
Okay.
That's a hint.
Yeah.
Aye, aye.
So, what's the deal with the special cargo?
It was some last-minute, top-level government contractor shipment.
It says there's an armed guard in the hole.
That's a first.
What are we carrying?
I'm not sure I want to know.
Well, looks like all the signatures check out, so we are free to drop it with the SOC.
It says here if there are any abnormalities involving the cargo area.
Abnormalities?
We're to contact Dr. Bennett and Dr. Sebastian. These were the guys that secured the cargo. They're in first class.
Abnormalities.
I'm glad this is my last flight.
Yeah.
Down.
You're not listening. We could lose Kelly, and I won't let that happen. You just...
Would you calm down? You're making a scene here. Now, I told you, I will bring Kelly out of stasis when we have a controlled environment, not before.
We all know this is highly unorthodox. We had to move quickly. This is our only way out.
Unorthodox?
Hey, she died. We saved her. If we hadn't intervened, she'd be dead. You goddamn well know that. Yeah. We'll be able to reach our friend.
Kalinske's made all the arrangements for the transport, and we'll see him in Prague.
Prague? I thought we had a lab set up in Tulum.
Crazy. Our files have been hacked. That'll be the first place they look.
We are running out of time!
There have always been risks. But think of the good we are doing. We will save loved ones. We will bring them back. It's why we all have sacrificed.
Kelly knew the risks going into this.
No, that's easy for you to say. That's not your wife down there. Is it? Is it?
Shh. Calm down. Sit down. Come on. tomorrow. I know how you feel. I really do. But do you for one minute think I don't know what's at stake here? My entire company depends on the success of this project, and I am less concerned about losing one life than I am of saving thousands. So I'm not going to let you or your wife or some petty little bureaucrat jeopardize this project. So shut the fuck up and get back to your seat, because this subject is closed for good. We're clear on this, Doctor.
We're clear. Excuse me.
He's not going to let this go.
Don't worry about it. Dr. Thorpe will not be leaving Paris. Not with us, at any rate.
Excuse me, miss. I'll take a rum and coke, please. Oh, sorry, Burroughs. Rude of me. Make that two.
Right. How about a coke?
If a little bit of Bacardi were to find its way in there, it would be our little secret, huh?
Anything for you, Mr.?
Burroughs, Truman. But no, thank you.
And I'm Frank. Frank Lee Strathmore. It's a name rich with tradition. My family...
She doesn't need to know your family history, Frank.
Look. I don't expect to be tied up long, just a couple of parking ticket kind of things, really. I mean, how about you and I meet at the Eiffel Tower around midnight?
I'm sorry to disappoint you, but Frank here, he's gonna be a little busy.
That's okay. Truman, if you guys need anything, let me know.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
Truman? I guess that pretty well does it for me. Looks like if you play your cards right, she could be cuffing you later.
You're gonna shut up and drink a coke.
Hey, guys.
Hey. My God, you are lovely. Stewardess, do you think I could get some sugar with my coffee?
Down, boy. So, is Allie packed?
She's been packed for 5 years.
The legendary Ray Bashore retiring. So why isn't she with you on your final flight?
She insisted on staying home to get things ready for our trip.
So where are you two going?
Summer vacation with the grandkids. Then we're on a slow ocean cruise to Alaska. Just the two of us.
That's so romantic.
Yeah, the ocean cruise maybe, but the kids? Sounds like a nightmare.
Hey. That's great, Ray, really.
Thank you.
Looks bad ahead, huh?
Not to worry.
Boring flight, boring flight.
So, I can't wait to go shopping at Chanel in Paris. Courtney says that we have to go to Cartier first, and then we can go
to... Yeah, well, I can't wait to go surfing in Biarritz.
Surfing?
Oh, yeah, we're going surfing.
You can go surfing.
Good.
You and that slut Jackie can go surfing all you want.
Whoa, hey, Tony's my friend, all right?
Mm-hmm.
We're here to surf and you know that.
And hey, his girlfriend's a total bitch, and you know that.
What the hell is it with you two?
I don't like her, okay?
Whatever, okay.
Whatever you sound.
Hey, yo, Tom.
Yeah?
Gotta go along, buddy.
Nice.
Oh, it hurts to get scored on.
Child. Whoa, nice toss.
Hey.
Thanks. I'll give it back to you when I'm done playing with it.
Hey. Dude, she cannot take the ball.
Well, obviously she can. Nice toss.
Excuse me, Mr. Freeman.
Yeah.
Can I get your autograph?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, that final putt on the last day of the Masters, man, that was poetry.
Oh, poetry, huh?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Here you go. Thank you.
Oh, thanks, Mr. Freeman. Thanks a lot.
No problem. Why can't they just leave us alone? You told me this was a trip away from golf and everything that goes with it.
I know, and it is. Look, I promise that for the rest of the trip, I'm just gonna be plain old Billy, all right? You won't even know Longshot exists. I promise you that.
Okay.
Well, that's fine.
Excuse me, Mr. Freeman.
Yeah.
Captain Bashore would love to meet you. When he has a break later in the flight, would you mind if he stops by for a visit?
Yeah, it's not a problem. Thank you.
Great.
You know, while you're at it, if you're done fawning over my husband, I'd love another Bloody Mary.
Anna.
William. I'm on vacation.
I'll get you a drink right away, Mrs. Freeman.
Yeah, and make sure you put some vodka in it this time. Because that's how I like to tee off.
Hey, there's no reason to be so rude, all right?
You know, I'm sure there's someone back in coach that hasn't got your autograph yet.
Well, maybe I'll go back there and give it to him. You knew what you were getting into when you married me.
I thought I did. You just keep twirling that little putter of yours. Because that's all you're going to be twirling this trip.
Wasn't so little last night, was it?
You know you've got the wrong man, right?
Yeah. That's why Interpol has your picture all over the internet.
It's a classic case of mistaken identity.
Yeah.
Hey. Hey. Burroughs. You can't treat me like this. I'm not guilty. It's not fair. Bouncing me all over the world to stand trial here and there for something I did not do. I'm not guilty. I'm not guilty. No, I have a clear conscience. I'm not guilty.
Yeah.
What is it going to take to convince you I'm innocent?
An act of God. Now shut up before I make you eat that flotation device you're sitting on.
There we go. We could fly around it, but not above it. And this is a huge system. It's about 150 miles east and west of course, so it looks like either way we go, we are screwed. It's either that or we fly all the way back around, but that's going to add 30 minutes to our flight at least.
Paris weather is not good for our arrival. I'm going to deviate left and thread the needle. That gap might be our only shot at getting around the system without landing for fuel. Folks, looks like it's going to get a little bumpy ahead. You might get a remain in your seats. Wear your seat belts. We'll probably be through this in 10 or 15 minutes. Thank you very much.
Madison, a combined strike team of the CIA and FBI seized the headquarters of Medcon Labs in Los Angeles. A number of arrests were made, but we've been unable to determine the whereabouts of four key individuals. The first one, Dr. Leo Bennett. He's a head research scientist and founder of Metcon, noted for his work with retroviruses and synthetic biology. He was investigated 2 years ago for illegal cloning research. Unfortunately, that investigation failed to produce any indictments.
So far, I've seen nothing that warrants disturbing the president. Can we get to the point here?
Look, we're trying to reconstruct Bennett's hard drive, and we think there is cause for alarm.
We believe Leo Bennett is responsible for the development of a new strain of the malaria virus and the containment and transportation of Dr. Kelly Thorpe.
Malaria.
Initially, we thought it was malaria. However, we discovered that it's something new, something different. Bennett obtained a DNA sample from a mosquito native to a remote area in Vietnam, which had a 100% mortality rate within seconds, which then regenerates that same organism for a few seconds or longer, depending upon the subject organism.
What Bennett has developed is a mutation of this same mosquito virus to restart major organs for an indefinite period of time.
So what you're saying is that his virus kills organs and then brings them back to life?
Not just organs.
He apparently was experimenting on the resurrection of the entire human body after death.
Oh, impossible. I can't go to the president with this. Jerry, come on.
From what we've uncovered, we believe he succeeded.
And communication problems. We just had a temperature drop in the cargo hold.
This is Concorde 239 to base. This is Concorde 239 to base. Great. No radio. And this crap for the next hour. Perfect.
What the hell is wrong with you? I'm sick. I need help. I need help. I'm a scientist with Medcon Labs. Where the hell is Dr. Bennett? I need to talk to someone! I'm coming out! Don't shoot!
Come out. I won't shoot.
Thank you.
Where is she?
I'm gonna go to the bathroom.
Okay. Hey, will you grab me a Diet Coke on the way back?
Sure, honey.
Thanks, babe.
Dude, check out that dime.
Wow, that is one hot little biatch. Ow, fuck, that hurt.
Oh, hi, honey. So I guess that mid-flight blowjob is out of the question?
Such a pig.
Sweetheart? What?
Come here.
What? What's wrong?
I mean, what if somebody sees us?
What are you we're in a bathroom. What are you talking about?
No, you know what I mean. You're Peter's best friend.
So what?
No, it's okay. I wasn't paying attention. Sir, you actually, you need to take your seat. Fasten seatbelt sign is on.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, can I get you some more coffee? Okay.
Yes, thank you.
You're welcome.
Megan rhymes with vegan. I was a vegan.
Yeah?
2 days. It's Megan vegan.
It's actually Megan.
Megan. Oh, no. I knew that.
Sir, you actually need to take your seat.
Okay, yeah. You need to be more careful. I mean, people sneaking up on you. There's strange people here. You never can tell what... what's going to happen on these flights?
Sorry, you need to take your seat.
Okay, thanks.
You're welcome.
Buckle up.
This little diversion will keep my mind off your tasteless cheap suit.
Would you feel better if I was in a bitch-ass orange jumpsuit? Like the one you're gonna be wearing the rest of your life?
There you go, getting nasty again when I am merely offering a criticism of this sartorial horror show you call a suit. However, I do like the shirt. Does it come in a man style? And for your information, the jumpsuits in France are a sort of burgundy. Yeah.
Well, you should look nice in that color. And I know what color corsage to get you when Big Pierre makes you his wife.
Someone sounds a wee bit jealous.
Yeah.
Cassandra will.
Over yet? Let's find out.
This is Randy.
It's Stacy. I think some of the passengers might have been hurt.
How bad?
I don't know. It's a mess down here.
Well, we'll do the best we can. Just stand by.
Looks like we're okay for a few minutes. Give him the go-ahead to check. Let me know what's what.
Well, folks, we apologize for the heavy turbulence we just experienced. It appears as though we're clear for the moment. However, we're traveling through some unstable air, so as a precaution, I would like you to remain in your seats for the time being. At this time, I would only like our flight attendants up and about the cabin. Thank you.
Would you make sure everyone's all right? Then have one of the doctors, Bennett or Sebastian, check the cargo situation out with you.
The cargo? I'll get my tools.
Is she okay?
It's her head.
You're right, dude. You take one?
The fucking bag hit me in the head.
Come on, that was fun. It's just turbulence. My God, don't be such a baby.
It didn't hit you.
Relax. What is your problem, girl? Oh, are you scared we're gonna crash? Relax, bitch. Enjoy the ride.
Whoa, Jesus. Pipe down, you psycho.
Shut up.
What the hell's wrong with
you? What? You are a psycho. Oh, you don't... And you're a fucking skank. I'm so sick of your shit.
Whoa, stop it.
Everyone just calm down. Take your seats. And you take your seats too. Take your seats.
What's wrong with you?
We have several warning lights we don't usually get, even with this weather.
It's probably nothing, but we should look just the same.
I agree. Why don't you two go with him?
Both of us? Right.
Well, whoever's going, meet me by that exit door. Usually takes a few minutes to get down there, and there's no easy way to go.
God damn it.
I told you. I told you.
Hey, you calm down.
Just go check on a passenger.
If there was a malfunction, Kelly might be dead.
Now, listen, don't take your eye off him. Make sure he doesn't do anything stupid.
Are you guys okay?
Yeah. I'm fine. But do you think we can move up to business class? I mean, the plane's really empty and all.
He's kidding. We're fine.
Okay.
Thank you.
Hey, I am trying to help you out here. She wants you. Make your move. Go, boy. Go.
I'm sorry if this is a problem.
No problem. I'll take care of it.
It could be dangerous.
Only if you're afraid of the dark.
Come on, Burrows. I need to go to the sandbox.
What?
I gotta pee.
No. You heard the PA. Sit down and hold it.
Fine. Oh, if you should happen to feel something warm, just move a little to your right.
You're like a 5-year-old. Come on.
Let's go.
Easy. Take it slow.
Yes, of course.
Burrows? Burroughs?
Mr. Burroughs. Truman. Oh, my God.
All right, gentlemen. Here we go.
Flight deck.
Captain, this is Megan at door 4L. We've got a problem back here.
Okay. How bad is it?
Mr. Burroughs, the cop who brought the prisoner on board, was knocked out cold. And his prisoner is missing.
Excuse me. You guys seen a funny-looking skinny guy, blue sweatshirt, turtleneck walk through here?
No.
No? No?
Well, that explains the communication problem.
Bri! Dr. Thorpe!
Kevin!
Fry's not in the jump seat.
What you got? This can't be happening.
We need to get out of here now! Come on! We need to seal the hatch now! Come on!
Tony? Tony? Don't scare me like that.
What? Where the fuck are you
Ow,
going?
That hurts. And don't use that kind of language around me either. Hey, you two. You need to be in your seats with your belts fastened.
Yourself a fucking sandwich while you're at it.
What have you done? You son of a bitch! What have you brought on board?
Take your seats over there. Please, take your seats.
Ray, open up!
What's wrong, Randy?
Ray, bring the plane down! Ray, bring the plane down! Bring the plane down right now, or we're all gonna fucking die!
Tell Ray, me what the hell happened
Ray,
down there!
The fucking scientists, they let something out of the cargo hold!
What are you talking about? Where are the doctors?
They're dead! Ray, they're dead! They're dead! Look at me, man! Everyone's gonna fucking die! They killed him!
Sit down and calm down! Sit down! Now! Sit down! What happened to you?
Listen to me. Just listen to me, Ray. If you don't land this plane, you, me, Emily, everybody on this fucking plane is gonna die.
You know I can't bring her down without warning and no place to land. Think about it!
There is something. Human. There, man. It is gonna kill everybody on board unless we land this plane. So whatever you do, I don't care how you
Look,
do it. Just find
down.
A place, Ray, and land the fucking plane.
Storm.
Find a piece of straight
this
fucking
storm
road!
Isn't helping our situation. It's clear we can try to cross, but I'm turning around and heading back. There's a TSA man aboard. Find out which passenger he is and get him up here. Now!
Ray.
Are you sure that's the guy?
Okay, they're dead. And you say whatever killed him wasn't human.
I know it sounds insane. I saw this happen. I mean, those things. I mean, they ripped those men apart. I mean, they were eating them.
You said there was a fugitive on board. Is it possible you saw him down there?
No! I told you, there were two of them, and these things aren't human. You know what? I'm gonna go find out what was in those containers.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna go talk to that asshole Bennett because he knows.
Sit down. I'll check it out. I'll report back.
Everything okay?
Any sign of him?
better than my ego.
Come on, he can't hide forever. As soon as the turbulence settles, I'm gonna look for him some more.
Don't go alone.
Why? Is he dangerous?
Well, he's probably never owned a weapon before, but he's more of a con artist than anything.
What did he do? Can you tell me?
He posed as an accountant, skimmed $35 million off the Russian mob, stole their jet, crash-landed it. And we finally caught up to him. Everybody wants him.
Why are you taking him to Paris? Oh!
Hey, take a look at this. I think I found Concorde 239.
Nobody's been able to reach it for over an hour.
Los Angeles Dispatch, this is Yellowknife Center. I believe I have your Concorde 239 on my screen. It's in the middle of two huge weather fronts and transponder indicates it's off course. No, no radio contact yet. I'll try now. Concorde 239, Yellowknife Center. Concorde 239, Yellowknife Center. Los Angeles Dispatch. Yes, I understand.
I repeat, you must tell 239 to return to U.S. airspace. The Canadian government will not permit them to land or continue to fly in their airspace. This decision has come from the highest level of the Canadian government, as well as the U.S. State Department and the CDC. Is that clear?
Can you tell me what it is you're transporting in the cargo hold?
Sorry. My cargo is a highly classified project linked to our nation's security. You don't have the necessary clearance.
I'm with the TSA, Federal Air Marshal. I need to know what's down there.
Well, how fortunate for us to have a man of your obvious talents aboard.
You seem a bit nervous, Doc. Is everything all right?
Just don't like flying.
Isn't it true your two colleagues accompanied the co-pilot down to the cargo hold because there was some problem?
No, no problem.
No problem.
It's just a routine mid-flight inspection.
Routine.
What I can tell you, while the cargo isn't dangerous, it is highly perishable and extremely valuable, so the cargo area is off-limits to unauthorized personnel.
Well, can you tell me...
No, I'm sorry. I said more than I should have already.
Judd, TSA, I believe your prisoner is in the cargo hold. Ready?
Hey, Frank! Dr. Thorpe! Dr. Sebastian! Anybody out there?
That's a lot of blood.
Somebody's in trouble.
Yeah, if it's Frank's, he needs help now. Check that out.
Looks like he escaped through the ducts.
I don't know. That's an awful lot of blood for a skinny little shit like Frank.
Go that way, I'll go this way. Be back in five.
All right.
Frank?
there, buddy? Now, why don't you come on out and talk to me, man? Everything's all right. It's cool. We can just talk. It's just me. Hey, Frankie?
I'm gonna kill that little shit.
All right. I'm coming up.
Yes. You're sure. Outstanding. Thank you, Lieutenant. We have located Bennett and his team.
Hallelujah.
You know, Frank, sometimes this job is really boring. This is not one of those times, bud. Making this real exciting. Son of a bitch.
Please take your seats. Everything is fine. Take your seats, okay? Please take your seats. Everything's fine. Thank you.
Hey, it's total chaos down here. There were gunshots or something that freaked out the passengers.
Emily! Go! Take the gun!
Happening.
Get back.
Go back to your seats and stay there! Go back!
Turn to run and we'll land the first place we can find.
And the only way back is through the center of the storm.
You need to get the passengers back to their seats now.
Okay.
Ah!
someone.
Shoot!
Oh, I can't explain. We gotta get out of here. Hey! Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
What is going on, man?
We need to hide. We need to hide. We need to get out of here. Be very quiet. Don't let him come, guys.
Callie, the floor's 2 feet thick. It's the only safe place.
I can't. My wife is upstairs.
Oh, shit.
Well, get her. Get back there as soon as you can.
Come on now.
Go, come on.
Right? No bites? Or...
We thought...
What? That it was me gnawing on all the passengers? No, I'm a vegetarian.
The scientists working on this is that we're dealing with a serum transfer virus. This virus is without a known vaccine or cure. But this type of virus transfer is only through bodily fluid, and then most effectively, blood from an infected victim enters a cut or saliva.
The MedCon scientists believe they could make this work, despite the side effects that are being brought back from the dead. In fact, they looked upon these side effects as a benefit.
Mm-hmm. Let me paraphrase these notes that we found at Dr. Bennett's desk.
They wanted this virus as a bioweapon, to keep soldiers fighting after they were mortally wounded, to release a captive enemy infected with the virus and let him infect others until they all kill each other.
I'm going to recommend to you and to the president that we destroy Flight 239 before it can reach a populated area.
Let me get this straight. You want our forces to follow a shoot-to-kill order regarding this civilian aircraft?
We've had no communication with the aircraft. We must assume the cargo has been breached and that the virus has spread throughout the passenger section. The only chance we have to contain this is to vaporize every living thing aboard that aircraft before the virus can reach a major population center.
Do you concur?
I'm afraid I do.
Can you get me the president, please?
Hey, I'm talking to you, man. It wasn't me. I was just following orders. They told me it was an experiment to extend life. I had no idea there'd be these crazy side effects.
Oh, well, look around, you asshole. Your side effects have eaten half the passengers.
Hey, I don't have to listen to you.
You were the one that seemed like you were given all the orders. And you were the one that the cop was talking to, and you were the one that sent the others below. I heard all of that.
You don't know what you're talking about. It wasn't me, I tell you.
Hey, keep your voice down.
You just keep talking. You draw their attention.
Really tight in here.
Yeah, I think we're getting closer.
Chest, one in the balls, that's what I say.
It's barricaded.
Ah, Frank, I see you!
You did that?
Busy little beaver.
Come on.
been? Where have I been? Where have you been?
Where have you been?
Where have you been?
I have been up and down this plane.
So have I!
Back off!
Statistically speaking, the tail section is the safest place to be in a crash. Of course,
no one break that now! Help me with it, Shelby!
Go, get some else! Get something else!
I am! Do it! Right there! Right there! I can't live!
There's a... Wait a minute.
Frank!
We gotta go.
All right, we need to find anything that can be used as a weapon.
Does anyone have anything sharp?
They confiscated my toenail clippers. Pearl handle. These matching tweezers, quite lovely.
Damn, Frank, you should have brought those. You could have saved a day.
You never know.
Yeah. How much ammunition do you have left?
I got 5 in here and 1 clip. What about you?
1 full clip, 5 more.
Maybe we could electrocute the bastard.
No, don't do that one!
I guess I could have gone better.
Frank, you stupid shit. Please tell me you're dead.
Where'd you find him?
The auxiliary lights.
Oh my God.
The auxiliary lights will come on any second. I hope.
Frank, thank you.
We need to find one of this.
Still no answer from the cockpit.
I can't believe everyone's dead. Oh my God, we're gonna die.
Megan, listen to me. Listen to me.
Yeah.
We are not gonna die.
No.
No,
okay.
We're not gonna die. I promise you. I need your help. I need you to be strong.
Did you see that?
What the hell was that?
Listen.
Someone's up there.
Don't shoot!
We need to have a plan to get this plane down safely.
Does anyone know if the pilot's still alive?
I tried to reach him.
Try him again.
Okay.
Nothing? The captain's dead. We're on autopilot.
So what, we just fly around until they get us?
Or until we run out of fuel.
Actually, that might be preferred.
Look. Run out of fuel?
Yeah!
Hey, we gotta get to the flight deck and check on the captain. We gotta do this now before they start coming at us.
I don't think you have enough bullets to make it to the cockpit.
The guard down below has a weapon.
Well, we need that weapon. That's our only chance.
So what, you're just gonna go down there?
Down there?
Yes!
How do we know he didn't use all the ammo already?
We don't know, Frank.
Good to know you still have a sense of humor at a time like this.
I know it's not much to look at, but with any luck, it's gonna buy me enough time to get that weapon and get back here without tearing the plane apart.
Why are you doing this?
I made a promise to someone. I keep my promises.
In case this blows off anything important. Do you mind if I take out your new girlfriend?
Hey, Bennett! Got something for you.
I think that's the cavalry, but,
What do you mean?
We don't have much time.
Well, aren't they gonna save us?
No, they're not gonna save us. There's just us. Unless we let him know we're alive, he's gonna shoot us down.
They can't do that.
He's right. Unless we answer him, they're gonna fire the missile at us.
What do we do?
We answer him.
Someone needs to get to the cockpit and signal that jet.
Does anybody know how to fly a jet? Anyone? Anyone? You can fly a jet?
Well, not officially, but I know most of the basics.
Basics?
Of course, it's been a while.
We just need to get to the radio and use it.
We need to go now, Frank.
Aw.
All right. Count me in.
No, 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 Billy, don't leave me.
I'll go.
No, no, you stay here. I'm gonna do my part.
Why?
I'll see you soon, baby. I'll see you soon. Let's go.
Such a big mouth. Nice drive.
Is that you, Ben? Come on, motherfucker. I want to make sure you keep that shitty girl in your face all the way to hell.
Go, 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 go!
Where's the autopilot?
I don't know, you asking me, Frank? This is different! This is different! Don't yell at me!
I'm not yelling!
alive. I repeat, we're alive. Abort. Abort.
Missile away.
Incoming object. Incoming object.
They must have launched a missile. Frank, we got seconds.
I know. Where is the autopilot?
I don't know.
Collision imminent. Collision imminent.
Here.
Autopilot off.
What do we do? Ready?
We've got live civilians. Warning. Repeat. I am a warning.
Did you ever consider going out with an ex-cop?
I went out with a cop once.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, the only thing he was good for was scratching my back when I couldn't reach.
Do you ever get that itch anymore?
All the time.
Thank you.
Regretting everything that you see.